And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the Minnesota Twins and the Arizona Diamondbacks. First pitch coming your way next.
And now, your 2022 Arizona Diamondbacks.
So just about set now. Now it's the veteran outfielder, Byron Buxton. The next pitch misses, and that's ball three. Up the middle. What a stop! Nicely done for the out.
Got a shot. The first baseman, number two, Luis Arraez.
Luis Arraez stands in. Mad bump deals. That's the third. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. And he beats it. That's a hit. Great try there. Now Correa up to hit. The pitch. That's inside. And that's a base hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Back-to-back base hits. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Two on, one out. Got it. And there's two down. So first and second with two outs. Max Kepler at the plate.
Max Kepler.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
Next pitch is inside, and it's 3-2. And he deals. And that one in the air center field. And the inning is over. Bottom of the first. Now the D-backs catcher, Dalton Varsho. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. Get down on strikes. One up, one down. Next up for the Diamondbacks, Paven Smith. The 1-1.
Smith.
In the air, left side. Gordon settles underneath it, hauls it in, and there's two away. Two outs, base is empty. And here's the veteran outfielder, David Peralta.
Peralta.
Bounced up the middle. Lays out. He's got it. On the money. Nice play. Back here at Chase Field, and here comes the power hitting catcher, Gary Sanchez. Here's a 1-1. That one fouled off. In today's game, you look at exit velocity as a measure of process, and if guys are hitting the ball hard, eventually the results usually follow. Gary Sanchez, he is a guy that hits the ball hard. And a swing and a miss. And one out now. Now it's the Twins DH, Jose Miranda.
Jose Miranda.
Next pitch is popped up. Marte makes the play, and there's two away. Two outs, base is empty. Gio Urshela to the plate.
Gio Urshela.
Back to work, 3-2 now. Stays alive. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And he walked him.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
That misses. Two balls, two strikes. Kicks and deals. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The 2-2. Swings and misses. And that is that. Bottom of the second. And now it's Christian Walker. The wide to kick the pitch. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Here's Josh Rojas. And that one lifted in the air center field. Buxton drifts towards it. He's got it. And there's one down. An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte.
Batting six. The second baseman, Ketel Marte.
The 1-1. That's off the mark. Now two balls and a strike. And he grounds one to the right side. And there's a hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. It's a team to bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Now batting Jordan Luplo. Next offering is fouled back. Got him. And there's two away. Nick Ahmed here to hit.
Not shortstop. Nick Ahmed.
The pitch. Popped up foul territory behind the plate. And makes the grab. And that is that. Well, here we go. Top of the third, scoreless game. And now Byron Buxton. The pitch. Tap back to the mound. Sneaks through, base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock.
Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield. And now they've got some speed on first. So we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Digging in, Luis Arraez. And a sack bunt here. Walker tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. And that's an out on the sacrifice. Here's Carlos Correa. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. Swing and a ball hammered left field. This one's got a chance. He can't get there, and that should be extra bases. Here comes Buxton flying around third. He's in there.
Always feels good when you come through and get your team on the board first. He somehow got to that outside pitch and pulled it hard into the outfield. Exactly what you're supposed to do with that kind of location, but you wouldn't know it by how the ball came off his bat.
Now batting Max Kepler.
The right fielder, Max Kepler.
One one now. And a foul ball. Runners are at the corners, one away. And down on strikes he goes. That's out number two. And Gary Sanchez at the plate. His first at bat was a strikeout. And a 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Now, that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
And now the lefty. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
Swing and a miss, and that is that. Back here in the desert, Alek Thomas now. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. Hard hit to third. And a quick out number one. And now it's Dalton Varsho.
The batter, the catcher, Dalton Varsho.
Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1.
2-1 to count.
On the ground at first. And he handles it himself for the out. Two outs, base is empty. Now, Paven Smith.
Paven Smith.
Left-hand hitter waits. Out to short. Correa picks it up. Sends it to first, and Arizona is set down 1-2-3. As we go to the top of the fourth, Gio Urshela steps in. And so the lefty allows the leadoff free pass. And next for Minnesota, Nick Gordon.
Number one, Nick Gordon.
Next pitch is outside. That one in for a strike, 2-2. The next offering misses. Full count now.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Next pitch is popped up. Rojas makes the play, and there's one down.
Well, that was a pitch you got to crush. Unbelievable that he missed it right there. I'm telling you, he is going to be frustrated with himself until his next at bat.
And now 2-2. And a swing and a miss. That's the second out. Luis Arraez, the next twin up to hit.
Luis Arraez.
The pitch.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
And a ball and two strikes. Hit weakly on the ground. In plenty of time to first. That's out number three. Back here at the ballpark, now the left fielder, David Peralta. And the pitch. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
He's been pitching well, but going through this middle of the order second time through, we'll see what kind of adjustments are being made.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
Now a screamer into the outfield. Kepler pulls that one down, and there's one away.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it, but sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
In for a strike. Now it's 3-2. Next offering is foul back. Stays alive. And there's ball four.
Now a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to play off some really close pitches, and somehow Bogey found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Kicks and fires. And that one handled. Over to Correa for one. Over to first. That's two. Nicely done. 1-6-3. And that will end the inning. Welcome back. And here comes Carlos Correa. Three-one is on the way. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. That takes care of Correa. And there's one away.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder that coming open instead of staying closed. Jorge. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Next offering misses. 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Next one misses. 3-1.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count. Be ready to turn on a fastball.
Three balls, two strikes the count. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The wind of the pitch. On the ground, right side. Gathers and throws to first. And the first two set down to the top of the fifth. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's the right fielder, Max Kepler. Bounce to the left side. Rojas throws on to first. That's the third out. And welcome back. We head to the bottom of the fifth. And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Ketel Marte. And a pitch.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff walk.
And the tying run is on base.
Almost a coin flip for the umpire in that call, but most umpires just don't want to give pitchers a break up in the zone like that.
Jordan Luplow will hit next. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Here comes a pitch. And there's a foul ball.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Out to center. One away. And now here is Nick Ahmed.
Number 13.
You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond. And this guy is at the top of the list. Out towards right center field. That one carry. Pulls it in on the warning track. Now up next for Arizona, Alec Thomas.
The center fielder, number 5, Alec Thomas.
In the air to left, down the line. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. That is the inning. So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, Noé Ramirez. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
So at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Top 6. Now at the plate, Gary Sanchez. And a 1-1. That misses the zone. And a count 2-1.
2-1.
Next pitch inside. 3 balls and a strike. And here it comes. Out to short. A dive. Nice stop. It's there, and that's a great play.
Now that designated hitter, Jose Miranda.
Jose Miranda, the next twin up to hit. Next one is off the plate. 2-1. Right-handed reliever. Fouls one off. 2-2. Righty to the plate. That one hammered center field. That's back. Hits the top of the wall. Played the plate, and he's out. He tried for the inside, the Parker, and he couldn't make it. Two outs, base is empty. Now the third baseman, Gio Urshela. Two down, nobody on. That one missed. And that's outside.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. And that is that. Well, we go bottom 6. Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Dalton Varsho. And a pitch. On the ground, right side. Polanco tosses to first. Leadoff man retired in the 6th.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense the work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
And a pitch. That's towards center. Buxton has this one sized up. And puts the squeeze on that one. 2 down. David Peralta at the plate.
The left fielder, David Peralta.
Next offering in the dirt. 2 balls and a strike. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Makes a nice running catch. And that will end the inning. Kyle Nelson on to pitch here. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Number 50, Kyle Nelson.
Top of inning number 7. Now here is Nick Gordon. wind of the pitch. Got him swinging. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
Now batting.
Here's Byron Buxton. I think when you contemplate him as a player, the first thing you think about is defense, and you think about that great arm.
I also think about the speed. If he can get on, that's going to give one more thing for that pitcher to think about.
3-2 now. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. That's his second strikeout. Luis Arraez, the next twin up to hit. 1-for-2. A wind in the pitch. In the air, left field. Peralta makes the catch, and that'll do it. Back here at Chase Field, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now the first baseman, Christian Walker. The tying run at the plate. Going to count 1-2.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Lined, and that's a base hit.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting in that at-bat. Off the bat, it was headed for the gap all the way. And as a hitter, you love seeing those as you take your first couple of steps out of the box. You know you've got some real estate to run on. It's such a good feeling. Nice liner into the gap right there.
Out on the sack bunt. Coming out of the bullpen for the Twins, Joe Smith. Now a runner on second to deal with. He'll do his best to keep him there.
Marte.
Here's Ketel Marte.
Listen, there's absolutely no reason to pitch to this guy right here. You nibble, you see if he'll expand his zone, but don't give him anything to hit. If you walk him, not a big deal. You have a double play opportunity set up.
The 1-2. In the air, left field. Makes the catch, and there's two down. Next to hit for Arizona, Jordan Luplo.
Number 8. Designated hitter, Jordan Luplo.
And it's second.
2-2.
Got him. That's the third out. Inning over. Now on the mound for the Diamondbacks, J.B. Wendelken. And he'll do his best to keep this close.
Number 48, J.B. Wendelken.
Back here in the desert, new inning getting started. And now for the Twins, Carlos Correa. At the belt and fires. Now a pop up on the infield. And there's one down. Jorge Polanco, the next twin up to hit for the fourth time tonight.
Now you get to this part of the order. Yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
Hit hard on the ground is short. Ahmed gets it to first. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth. Next to hit, Max Kepler.
Right fielder, Max Kepler.
And the righty deals. Foul ball there. And now it's 1-2. Backed off the plate that time. Left-hand batter waits. Popped up. makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Yoan Duran. And he'll work on holding this lead.
They know that he can get a right-hander out, but he's in position to face a couple of lefties this inning.
Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Now, here is Nick Ahmed. Next pitch misses inside. Ball two.
Two balls, one strike.
That's out to center field. And it drops in. But a good job to keep it in front.
Well, that at bat had a lot riding on it. Certainly a pivotal swing of the bat in this ball game. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
And here is Alec Thomas to second, but way too late, safe there.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
Runner leads away at second. Got him! One out. Dalton Varsho stands in now for the Diamondbacks. So the tying run at second.
These fans, they are ready to cheer about something.
The pitch. Bounce to the right. Fires to first, and that's an out. So digging in, Paven Smith.
Now batting.
This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, but not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Huge strikeout there. Back here at the ballpark, all set for the start of the inning. Here's the power hitting catcher, Gary Sanchez. Righty delivers. A little out front there as he swings through it.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
And now the count is even. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And they get the leadoff man in the ninth. Now Jose Miranda digs in now, one for three.
Miranda.
Kicks and deals. Falling behind 2-1. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Stays alive. Next pitch inside, and now it's 3-2. And he deals. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. Here's Gio Urshela.
Gio Urshela.
Right-hander kicks, deals. That one fouled off. 2-2. One-run game here at the top of the ninth. And the right-hander deals. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. And two away now. Nick Gordon, the next to hit.
Nick Gordon.
The pitch. Ground ball, Walker. Takes it himself. Third out. We're back, and on the mound is the closer, Emilio Pagan, trying to protect his lead. And welcome back. Here's the left fielder, David Peralta. The 1-1. Pitch misses, and it's 2-1.
Well, an interesting situation. One swing, you can tie up the ball game. But if you're patient and work a walk, then you bring the game-winning run to the plate.
And that one hit to first, and he takes it himself for the out. Christian Walker getting ready to hit.
The first baseman, Christian Walker.
Ball to strike.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
One down, base is empty. And a 2-1 hammered but foul. In the air to left center, Buxton gets there. He's under it and puts the squeeze on that. And there are two outs. Next up for the Diamondbacks, Josh Rojas.
Third baseman, Josh Rojas.
The 1-1. Swing and a miss. One and two. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. In time ball game, and the strikeout ends it.
Well, this one was all about the pitching and defense. Outstanding job of the pitchers, really attacking hitters, trusting what the catcher was putting down, and trusting the guy standing behind him to make the plays defensively. Sometimes you want to see a high scoring game, but sometimes you can appreciate the artistic beauty of what these guys did on the mound today.
And a 1-0 final score here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.
The final line score for our ball game tonight, for the victorious Twins, 1 run, 5 hits,